thank you, sir.
Do you approve?
Oh, yes. It's beautiful.
Well, let's go in. She died a long time ago. But from now on, it will be known as Anna's room. Dolly, I want you to help Miss Anna in any way that you can.
Yes, sir.
Well, Anna, are you pleased?
Well, I see from that that you are.
Dolly, I think the first thing we must do is to get Miss Anna bathed and dressed.
Oh, yes, sir. I'll get the bath ready right away, sir.
Perhaps you could find something from my wife's wardrobe suitable for Miss Anna to wear this evening for dinner.
Oh, yes, sir. There's the pink dress, sir. Miss Anna will look lovely in that.
Yes. Well, Dolly seems to know where everything is. So don't hesitate to ask her for anything that you may want.
Don't you worry, sir. You'll never recognize her, sir. Come on, Miss Anna. One thing you've got to learn around here is to affect what Dr. Pritchard calls a happy countenance. Which means he likes to see people with smiles on their faces, he does. Not that he's a great one for smiles and giggles himself. Know what I mean? Not like us.
I wasn't crying because I was sad, Dolly. I was crying because I was happy. It's such a beautiful room.
I know you were, Miss Anna. Oh, it's all right, Miss Anna. It's only Dr. Pritchard.
All right, Anna, at my age, one tends to treat modesty as an affectation of the ugly.
Would you fit Miss Anna a treat, sir?
Yes, see how this goes with the dress.
Oh, sir, it's lovely.
We'll be at the restaurant within the hour, Anna, my dear. As soon as I can pull myself free of this wretched crowd at the embassy. I've left you the carriage, and Pleasance will see you to the door. Dolly. Don't let her out of your sight until she's in the carriage. She's had a very disturbing day. She needs company.
All right, sir. Oh, Miss Anna. You're going to look like a proper princess tonight. You just wait and see.
I think I must leave you. I'm very worried about Anna. She should have arrived a long time ago.
Well, we shan't be late.
Laura, Mrs. Bryant will look after you when you return.
Thank you, Dr. Pritchard. I'm sorry, Michael. Something seems to have spoiled the evening for your father.
But not for me.
Oh, Dolly, it's so beautiful. I'm afraid to move before our wicker.
You're not asleep, Miss Anna. Here, take a look at the back.
Dolly, do you have to call me Miss? I'd much prefer us to be friends.
Oh, no, miss, that would never do at all. You can't have the likes of me talking to a lady on such familiar terms.
But I'm not a real lady yet.
You just wait till you see yourself in this. Oh, Miss Anna, you're going to look lovely tonight. Everybody's going to be looking at you. You're going to be the belle of the ball. You just wait and see. There, it'll look lovely on that dress. There now. Oh, Miss Anna, do you like it? Oh, you do like it. I knew you would. Miss Anna, you look just like a little doll all done up to meet the Queen. I'll kiss you now, then, before you become a lady.
Anna.
I want you to go to the restaurant and tell Mr. Michael and Miss Laura that you're waiting for me. I'll take a cab if I need one.
Very good, sir.
Stay here. Stay here. Dolly?
Come with me.
Here. We should be at the restaurant.
It's all right. It's very late. You've had a long day.
Mm.
very sleepy.
Yes, I am very sleepy. Has anything happened?
Nothing, my dear. You dozed off and had a bad dream.